This question came in 2014 for EC for 2 marks. The question is, for the MOSFET M1 shown in the figure, assume W by L is equal to 2, VDD equal to 2 volts, and mu and Cox is given, which is 100 microampere per volt square, and the threshold voltage is given 0.5 volts. The transistor M1 switches from saturation region to linear region when Vin in volts is dash. So if you look at the circuit, or in general, MOSFET is in saturation region if VDS is greater than VGS minus VTH, and it is in linear region when VDS is less than VGS minus VTH. And of course, when VDS is equal to VGS minus VTH, it is actually the boundary between both the regions. So we are supposed to find the Vin at which we are right between these two regions where it switches. So we need to find Vin corresponding to VDS equal to VGS minus VTH. Of course, in this figure, VGS is equal to Vin. VDD is given 2 volts. Let's write the equation here. That is, VDD is equal to the voltage drop across the 10 kilo ohms plus the voltage across the MOSFET. We know VDS should be equal to VGS minus VTH. So let's write this 10 kilo ohms times ID plus VDS is equal to VGS minus VTH. VD is 2 volts. We need to find what is ID. ID is equal to mu Cox, which is 100 microampere per volt square, times W by L, which is 2, times VGS minus VTH whole square divided by 2. 2 cancel. Now ID is equal to 100 microampere per volt square times VGS minus VTH whole square. Now let's substitute this ID back here. 10 kilo times 100 micro is 1 times VGS minus VTH. We have VGS minus VTH whole square plus VGS minus VTH. Now we can say 2V is equal to X square plus X. So we need to find what is value of X first. So X square plus X minus 2 is equal to 0. X can be written as minus 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 8 divided by 2. This we get either minus 2 or plus 1. Where we know X is equal to VGS minus VTH, obviously this value cannot be negative because we are talking about a situation where the transistor is right in between saturation and linear, at which obviously the transistor should be on, which means VGS should be greater than VTH. Hence, the right value we have to take is 1. In that case, we know what is VTH value, which is given 0.5. Hence, VGS, which is also equal to Vin, should be 1.5 volts. So hence, the answer would be 1.5.